Ubuntu running off a Synology NAS? You might think it's virtually impossible, but it's not. It's TechWiz time. Hey guys, it's Jonathan here with TechWiz time. This video is part of a series of Synology NAS videos about getting more from your NAS. For previous videos, click on the link above or the link in the description below. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install a Ubuntu virtual machine on a compatible Synology NAS. So before we get started, you will need a few things. Firstly, you will need a compatible NAS. The ones listed here are the current models compatible with the Virtual Machine Manager package. Secondly, you will need 4 GB of RAM or more. This is extremely important as you will need to allocate a chunk of memory to each virtual machine you create. And finally, you will also need a BTRFS volume setup. Previously, the Virtual Machine Manager package was known as the Virtual DSM Manager. If you've been using the Virtual DSM Manager package, the upgraded Virtual Machine Manager provides new features over the original. So be sure to upgrade if you haven't already. So, why would you want to use the Virtual Machine Manager package on a Synology NAS? Great question. You can set up and run Windows, Linux, or DSM virtual machines in one physical location on a Synology NAS. Here you can safely test new versions of software isolated from customer machines, all while increasing the flexibility of your server. With that said, let's get into the tutorial. Just to let you guys know as well, this video is sponsored by Synology. They provided the NAS so I could do the necessary steps in order to make this tutorial a reality. So to get started, you'll need to download the Ubuntu image. Once you have the ISO image on either your primary computer or Synology NAS, we can sign up to the beta program via the Package Center. In the Synology DiskStation web interface, we need to click on the top left-hand menu and select the Package Center icon. Across the top now, we need to click on the Settings button. Now we need to go to the Beta tab and place a tick beside the Yes, I want to see beta versions checkbox. Click on OK and from here we need to choose the Utilities section on the left and scroll to the bottom until we see Virtual Machine Manager. Here we can click on the icon to see more details or click on the Install button to do exactly that. Once the Virtual Machine Manager is installed, we can access it by going to the DiskStation menu and clicking on the Virtual Machine Manager icon. On the first launch, we will be presented with a wizard. This will be telling the package where we want to store the virtual machines we create. So click Next, and here we can put a check beside the BTRFS volume we want to use. Now when we click Next, you will need to select the secondary LAN connection. Clicking Next again will produce a message in regards to isolating network interfaces through different subnets. Now clicking on Yes will produce a warning that the network interfaces will be restarted, so click Yes again. It should only take around 30 seconds or so to come back with a big green tick. Then we just need to click on the Finish button. Now that we've set up the Virtual Machine Manager package, we can set up the Ubuntu ISO image. Inside the Virtual Machine Manager package, select System Image down the left-hand side. Here we just need to click the Create button along the top, and under Name, we will give this the name we'll recognize when we get to creating the virtual machine. Next, we'll choose the type as an ISO file. And next, we'll have to choose where we downloaded the Ubuntu image from. In my case, I have the image located on the disk station, so I select that and click on the Browse button. Select the image once you've located it and click on the blue select button. Now we can click Next. Here we place a tick next to our NAS and click on the blue apply button. And after a short wait, we will see we've created our first system image. Awesome! So we've created a system image, which by the way, can be done with other ISO files too. Now we're going to create our Ubuntu virtual machine. So in the DiskStation web interface inside the Virtual Machine Manager package, we need to choose Virtual Machine down the left-hand side. Across the top, click on the Create button and choose Create. The creation method we will be using here is the ISO file method, so choose that one and click Next. Now we can configure all the specs for our virtual machine. The first thing we want to do is give it a name. In my case, Ubuntu is perfectly fine. Next in line is the amount of CPU cores we want to use. It is recommended to choose a minimum of 2 CPU cores for a virtual machine to run effectively. RAM is something that is dependent on your free RAM available. Generally though, 2 GB is a good starting point for most systems to run. Under ISO file for boot up, we need to choose the system image we created before. We can skip the next two, but for virtual disks, we need to allocate space for the virtual machine. 25 GB is the recommended amount of space required, so to be safe, I'm choosing 30 GB here. Now we will click the blue Next button. Here's where we assign permissions. Select accounts you want to have permissions to use this virtual machine and click Next. We will get confirmation of our settings, so just click Apply. The Ubuntu virtual machine is now configured. From here, we can now power on our newly created virtual machine. To start up the virtual machine, click on the action button up top and choose Power On. With our Synology NAS selected, we can now hit the Apply button. Now we just need to click the Connect button up top to open our virtual machine in a new browser tab. The Ubuntu system will start to boot, and on the welcome screen, we just need to select our language and click the Install Ubuntu button. To ensure everything is up to date, we can select these two options to install updates and third-party software whilst Ubuntu is being set up. Then just click the Continue button. Here we need to ensure Raise Disk and Install Ubuntu is selected, and my preference here is to use LVM and click on Install Now. A message may come up confirming changes to the virtual disk, so we'll click on Continue. After a short moment, we'll be prompted to choose our location for system settings. I've chosen Sydney, and then I click on Continue. Choose your keyboard layout and language and click Continue. Lastly, we need to set up the user account details. Here you will need to input your name or a pseudoname, which will form your computer name. You can change this to whatever you want, so don't feel pressured to stick with the default. Choose your username and password before pressing on the Continue button. This process will take around 30 minutes or so make a coffee, watch an episode of Stranger Things on Netflix, and come back to your web browser. We should see a screen telling us that the installation is complete, and we just need to click on the Restart Now button. Before we do that though, we need to go back to the Disk Station interface. Here we need to click on the Edit button up top, and under ISO file for boot up, we need to change that to Unmounted. Now we can go back to the Virtual Machine tab and click on Restart Now. Once Ubuntu is fully rebooted, we'll need to log in with the username and password that you set up at the start. And look at that, we've launched Ubuntu, but before we get excited, we need to do one last thing. On the left-hand side up top, click on the search icon here and type in the word terminal. You should see it come up in the list, so let's click on that now. Here we need to install QM Guest Agent. This simply allows the host, which is Synology NAS, to communicate with the virtual machine properly, allowing you to shut down or restart the virtual machine without connecting to it directly. To install QMU Guest Agent, simply type in sudo apt-get install qmu-guest-agent and press enter. And when it asks for it, put in your password and the installation will begin. After a few short moments, the software will be installed and you are finished. So let's recap. I showed you how to install the Virtual Machine Manager package, how to set up a system image for the Ubuntu ISO, create the virtual machine and virtual disk, set up Ubuntu and install QMU Disk Agent. Now you've got a Ubuntu virtual machine running on your Synology NAS. Awesome! If Linux isn't your thing, then I have a Windows Virtual Machine tutorial coming up very soon, so make sure you've subscribed. And if you have a NAS related video you'd like to see, then leave me a comment down below and let me know. Like and share this video wherever you can, and as always, imagine, learn, create.